हेलो फ्रेंड, नमस्कार। आई एम जेके। वी आर लकी टू हैव डॉक्टर के मोहन सर टुडे विद अस। आई हैव इनवाइटेड एंड रिक्वेस्टेड हिम टू शेयर हिज थॉट, लर्निंग एंड नॉलेज ऑन सीमेंट केमिस्ट्री विद अस। ही विल बी स्पीकिंग एंड टॉकिंग टू अस ऑन ए सीरीज ऑफ टॉपिक्स रिलेटेड टू सीमेंट केमिस्ट्री। सो देर विल बी ए होल सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर एंड टॉक बाई हिम। दिस इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ द सीरीज। डॉक्टर के मोहन सर नीड्स नो इंट्रोडक्शन। हाउएवर, आई विल लाइक टू से फ्यू वर्ड अबाउट हिम एंड हिज अचीवमेंट। ही इज एन इंटरनेशनली रेनाउंड एंड एक्लेम्ड सीमेंट साइंटिस्ट। ही इज फॉर्मर डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ नेशनल काउंसिल फॉर सीमेंट एंड वेल्डिंग मटेरियल, NCCBM। ही हैज ए वरीड, वास्ट एंड रिच एक्सपीरियंस of over 51 years in teaching, research, management, training, consultancy, technology, development and transfer in cement and concrete science and technology in India and abroad. He holds a PhD degree in cement chemistry from University of Aberdeen, Scotland, UK. He has carried out 8 years of original path-breaking and pioneering research work at University of Aberdeen in the field of cement chemistry and technology under Professor H.F.W. Taylor, who is referred as a father of modern cement chemistry, and Professor F.P. Glaser. He has 70 research publications in reputed national and international journals and 9 patents to his credit. His research finding has been widely quoted in prestigious international journals and books on cement and concrete. He has widely traveled abroad and visited 15 countries in connection with his professional assignments. He has been an external examiner of many foreign and Indian universities. He is Bhish Pitama of cement chemistry. Now, I would like to invite Dr. K. Mohan sir. Namaskar, sir.
Namaskar, Mr. J.K. Singh. Thank you so much for inviting me to share my thoughts on different topics related to cement chemistry. As you are aware, presently I'm involved in teaching cement chemistry and concrete science to postgraduate students of a couple of prestigious universities as a visiting faculty. In one of the universities, I have designed syllabus on cement chemistry for MSc final chemistry students, and I teach them cement chemistry. In another university, I teach the engineering students concrete science. The objectives of my making a series of educational videos on cement chemistry are twofold. One is to create interest and awareness amongst school, undergraduate, and postgraduate students about cement, its chemistry, and technology. And the second is to share and pass on whatever little knowledge and learnings I have gained on cement chemistry and technology over the years, more than half a century, to younger generation and working professionals of cement industry. I do hope that they will be benefited by watching these educational videos, and that will give me immense satisfaction. Well, now coming to the topic of cement, let us first understand what is cement. Cement is nothing but it is a hydraulic binder, that is an inorganic, non-metallic, finely ground substance which, after mixing with water, sets and hardens as a result of chemical reactions with the mixing water, and after hardening, it retains its strength and stability even underwater.
Sir, I have one question. I would like to know who invented cement. Sir, cement ka invention kaun kiya tha?
Well, I was going to come to that. The first occurrence of Portland cement came about in the 19th century. In 1824, Joseph Aspadin, a British mason, bricklayer from Leeds, took out a patent on a hydraulic cement that he called Portland cement. Because of its similarity to Portland stone, a type of building stone that was quarried on the Isle of Portland in Dorset, England, a peninsula in the English Channel. Now I will discuss about the raw materials which are used for the manufacture of cement, their characteristics and quality requirements. There are three types of raw materials which are used in the production of cement. They are, number one, calcareous materials, number two, argillaceous materials, and number three, corrective materials. Now I will discuss about calcareous materials. Calcareous materials are calcium-bearing carbonates. Calcium materials are, for example, limestone, which contains 95 to 100% of calcium carbonate, CaCO3. Then marly limestone, it contains 75 to 85% of CaCO3. Chalk, it contains 95 to 100% of calcium carbonate. Marble, it contains 95 to 100% of calcium carbonate. Lime sand, it contains 85 to 95% of calcium carbonate. Silt deposits, it contains 85 to 95% of CaCO3. So limestone is the main raw material used in cement manufacturing. And limestone contains lime, that is CO, silica, that is SiO2, alumina, that is Al2O3, and iron oxide, that is Fe2O3, as major oxide. Beside that, we have minor components like sodium oxide, Na2O, potassium oxide, K2O, chloride, Cl, SO3, sulfate, manganese oxide, Mn2O3, chromium oxide, Cr2O3, titania, TiO2, etc. So these are minor oxides, minor components in limestone. Limestone is basically a source of lime, CaO. The main mineral present in limestone are calcite, aragonite, and dolomite. Now, one by one, I will discuss. Calcite, the crystal system is hexagonal, rhombohedral. And in calcite, you can have substitution of manganese, iron, and magnesium. And calcite has a specific gravity of 2.72. And its dissociation temperature is 898 degrees centigrade. That is, it dissociates at 898 degrees centigrade into CaO and carbon dioxide. Next, aragonite. It is also calcium carbonate. Crystal system is different. Crystal system is orthorhombic. And their common substituents are strontium, lead, zinc. The specific gravity is different, 2.94. And initially, it starts dissociating at 425 degrees centigrade. That aragonite gets converted into calcite. And finally, it decomposes into 898 degrees centigrade. And finally, we have that mineral dolomite, that is a calcium carbonate, mixture of calcium carbonate and magnesium carbonate. Crystal system is hexagonal, rhombohedral, and common substituents are iron, manganese, cobalt, and zinc. And it has a specific gravity of 2.86. The dissociation temperature, initially it starts 725, that is magnesium carbonate decomposes, and final decomposition is 890 degrees centigrade.
आशा करते हैं दोस्तों, आज आपको अच्छी खासी जानकारी हासिल हुई होगी. अगर हमारा वीडियो आपको पसंद आया हो, लाइक और शेयर जरूर कीजिएगा. अगर हमारे यूट्यूब चैनल पर नए हैं, सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें. बेल आइकन को जरूर हिट कीजिएगा, जिससे आपको लेटेस्ट अपडेट नोटिफिकेशन मिलता रहेगा, हमारा मोटिवेशन बढ़ता रहेगा. और दोस्त, मैं एक चीज़ और आपको बताना चाह रहा हूँ कि आने वाले सीरीज़ में आपको सीमेंट से रिलेटेड जितनी भी जानकारी आनी है, केमिस्ट्री से रिलेटेड, वो सारी वन बाय वन आती रहेंगी. आप बने रहिए और इंतज़ार करते रहिए, बने रहिए, नोट उसका बनाइए. और सीमेंट केमिस्ट्री की पूरी जानकारी आपको इस चैनल के द्वारा प्राप्त हो जाएगा. वीडियो देखने के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.